Good morning, class. In last week, we had discussed about the chapter crop production and its management, in which we had discussed the objective question answers. Today, we will go with the question answers given in your exercise. Before that, I am just summarizing the topic that we had discussed in our previous classes. So basically, in this chapter, we had read about the meaning of agriculture and the different steps involved in crop production. The practice or business of agriculture is called farming. Agriculture depends on two factors. One, production of crop. Second one, raising of domesticated animals. The animals play a very important role in agriculture, and many of the products we get from the animals. So agriculture is actually relates with both the crop production as well as the raising of the livestock. Livestock means the animals which helped us in different ways. Clear? Then we had discussed about the different steps involved in the agriculture, in which we had discussed about the preparation of soil that is done by the plowing and the tilling method with the help of the different tools and the agricultural implements. And after that, we had discussed about the selection of the seed when the soil bed is prepared. The second steps comes, it is the selection of the seed. The healthy seeds were selected or are selected by the farmers so that the yield of the crop will be in a better way. After the selection, the third step is your sowing of the seeds. The seeds are sown into the soil or into the bed by different method, manually or by the help of the different machines. After sowing, the method after sowing is used irrigation. Irrigation is very important steps in the step in the agriculture, that is the supplying of water to the field. And after that, the removal of the weeds, that is weeding the unwanted plants. Then we had read about the natural method of addition of nitrogenous requirement into the soil, like your crop rotation, mixed cropping, etc. When we use the method of crop rotation or mixed cropping, actually what we did, we have added the mineral content in the natural method. But the crop rotation and the mixed cropping, these methods are not actually so much powerful to add the mineral contents in the soil or to increase the fertility of the soil. So the farmers, besides doing all these practices, they also use the addition of the manures and the fertilizers to the soil to increase the fertility of soil, which in turn will help the growth of the plants and the crops in a better way. And then the after the maturity of the crop, the protection of the crops from the insects or the pest, that also we had discussed. When the crops get matured, the method comes for its cutting. It is known as harvesting. After harvesting, the grains are collected from the matured crop, which is known as threshing. Threshing also we had discussed. After threshing, the method winnowing, the separation of grains from the husk, that also we discussed. And then after the separation of grains from the husk, the next step comes, it is your proper storage. The grains are properly dried under the sun and then it is stored in a proper container or a silos. And after that storage, then the next method system that we had discussed about the different genetically modified crops. So all these topic we had discussed, okay. And then last to last class we had discussed some of the extra topics related to the animals, that is apiculture, pisciculture, and then aquaculture, etc. So let's move with the next section, that is the discussion of the question answers given in your book. Party, the first question is, why is the use of a seed drill more advantageous as compared to sowing seeds by broadcasting? What is seed drill? Seed drill is an implement which is used for sowing the seeds. As I discussed during the discussion, that it is made up of a funnel shaped structure which is opening into a long pipe, and when it is attached at the back of the plow, the seeds are dropped into the funnel, and as the plow moves, the seeds get planted in the furrows, the rows made by the moving plow. Then what is the meaning of broadcasting? The broadcasting is the method of sowing the seeds manually, just by spreading the seeds with the help of the hand. Now the question is asking why the seed drill is more useful or advantageous as compared to the sowing seeds by broadcasting. See, when the seeds are sown into the soil manually, then there may be a chance that the sowing of seeds will not at a proper distance and at a proper depth. But when we use a seed drill, means when we make a proper hole with the help of an implement, then the distance maintained between the seeds will be uniform, as well as the seeds will get a proper depth into the soil. Now you can see what I have written here. Seed drill is better as compared to sowing seeds by broadcasting, as number one, when we drill the seeds, we place them at the appropriate distance and depth. The distance between the seeds will be uniform due to the use of the seed drill. But when we broadcast or when we just sprinkle the seeds, the uniformity between the seeds will not be there. Number two, it also ensures that seeds get covered with soil and saved from being eaten by birds. When the seed drills are used to make the hole, after making hole, when the seeds are dropped, it is covered with the help of the moist soil. Hence, it is saved from being eaten by birds or any other animals. But when broadcasting method is done, the seeds are scattered in a non-uniform manner. Hence, what happens? Many of the seeds will remain on the top of the soil, which may be eaten by the birds. That's why it is said that seed drill is better as compared to the sowing seeds by the broadcasting method. Clear? The third point, that why it is more useful than broadcasting. When we use a seed drill, the seeds goes into the deep into the soil or attain the proper height. Hence, the seed germination will be in a very good way. Means it helps in improved seed germination. Most of the seeds will germinate into seedling, but broadcasting method, the seeds will not enter the soil. It may remain on the top of the soil, which may cause the death of many of the seeds, and hence the many of the seedlings will not germinate. However, when we broadcast the seeds, proper distance is not maintained, resulting in poor output. Hence, the result or the growth of the crop will not be optimum or acquired. Hence, it is termed as resulting in poor output. Clear? Question number two is, Babu wants to practice crop rotation. Babu wants to practice crop rotation. help him by suggesting what kind of crops can be grown between two consecutive cereal crops. Also, half of the questions only I have written here. Let me read the full question. Also, provide him names of one rabi and one kharif crop that can be used to replenish the nitrogen content of the soil. The question says that Babu is the name of a boy. He wants to practice the crop rotation. Did you remember the meaning of the crop rotation? And you have to suggest the name of a crop which can be grown between two consecutive cereal crops. If you could remember, while teaching this crop rotation practice, I told you cereal 1 and cereal 2. If cereal 1 is grown in one season and cereal 2 is grown in the another season, there is a time gap in between two cereals, which is a small time gap. The farmers used to plant the leguminous or the pulse plant in between the time gap of two consecutive cereals. Why? Because these leguminous plants add the nitrogenous requirement or content into the soil. Means it increase they in this plantation of leguminous plant increase the fertility of soil by adding nitrogen into it. Okay, now we have to suggest the name of one rabi crop and another kharif crop that can be used to replenish the nitrogen content of the soil. But before that, let us rewind the meaning of the crop rotation. What is crop protection? Crop rotation, the process of growing a crop in between two similar crops is called crop rotation, or two different crops. The process of growing a crop in between two cereal crops is called crop rotation. For example, wheat crop is planted during the month of November and harvested in March and April, whereas the rice crop is planted in June or July and harvested in October and November. Now, in between these two seasons, what I told you, this is your wheat crop which is planted in the month of November, okay, and harvested in the month of March or April. Clear? Whereas the rice crop is planted in June or July and harvested in October. Now, in between these two seasons, the land lies empty. There is a time gap. The land lies empty. So, what farmer does? The farmer, instead of leaving it as it is, the farmers plant a pulse crop in this time. This pulse crop does not take long time as the wheat or rice take time to grow. So, within a small time gap, the pulse is ready for harvesting, and also it adds the nitrogenous content into the soil. This method is known as crop rotation. Now see what I have written here as answer. Babu can plant leguminous plants or pulses between two consecutive cereal crops. First question asks, Babu wants to practice the crop rotation. Help him by suggesting what kind of crops can be grown between two consecutive cereal crops. So Babu can plant leguminous or pulses between two consecutive cereal crops. Now we have to suggest the name of one rabi crop and one kharif crop which adds the fertility or which adds the mineral content into the soil to increase the fertility of soil. So here what I have written, one rabi crop is wheat. Rababu should plant one rabi crop, that is wheat, and one kharif crop is soya bean, which increases the fertility of the soil by adding nitrogen into it. The wheat and the soya bean, the wheat rabi plant and the soya bean the kharif plant. The wheat rabi plant and the soya bean the kharif plant, they are used to replenish the nitrogen content of the soil. Question number 3. If rice is sown in the month of November, how is the produce likely to be impacted and why? Clear? What is the answer? Once again, read the question. If rice is sown in the month of November, how is the produce likely to be impacted and why? The answer I have written here, rice, which is a paddy plant, is a kharif crop, which is sown in rainy season. It requires lot of water for its growth. During winter, large amount of water is not available. It would also not get enough temperature. Due to water scarcity and unfavorable condition, the cultivation of crop is highly impacted, become dry and may not grow well. Rice needs plenty of water and hence it depends on the monsoon for the cultivation. But if we sow this rice seed in the month of November, that frequent rainfall cannot be seen. Hence, first problem, there may be scarcity of adequate water for the cultivation of seeds. Second, the winter season is about to approach, the temperature will fall down. It would also not get enough temperature. In the cold temperature, the rice plant may not survive. So these two reasons, due to water scarcity and unfavorable condition, that is the low temperature, the plant will not grow in a proper way. It will be impacted badly. It will become dry and may not grow well. So rice seed cannot be sown in the month of the November. Question number D4. What are crumbs? Why should they be broken? When we plow the soil or when we prepare this bed for cultivation, we must have seen the big pieces of soil comes out during the loosening of the soil. It is termed as crumbs. Why it should be broken? The answer is, the crumbs are the big pieces of the soil formed when the field is plowed. The crumbs are the big pieces of the soil formed when the field is plowed. They should be broken first for proper air circulation in the soil. When the big piece of soil, it is broken into smaller pieces, it increases the spaces between the soil particles, which leads the proper air circulation. The root will be able to breathe properly due to increased space in between the soil particles. Number 2, when the soil particles will be in a smaller size, the roots will penetrate into the soil or will go very deep into the soil in search of water and will fix the plant into the soil very strongly. So very important that the big pieces of soil, it should be broken into smaller pieces. First, for the proper penetration. Second one, the root will spread properly into the soil for firm grip. Number 3, for good germination of the seedlings. When the seed will be sown with the help of the seed drill or some of the seeds through the broadcasting method, the seeds will go proper go in the soil with a proper depth, and hence the seed will germinate properly into seedlings. So these are the three points which is very important. Hence the soil should be loosened properly. There should not be big pieces of soil like crumbs. It will affect the quality or the production of the crop and the grains. So for a proper air circulation, for the better penetration and for the good germination of the seedlings, it is very important that the big pieces of the soil should be broken down into smaller pieces with the help of the agricultural tools and implements. Okay, question number D5. Define the term transplantation and list any two advantages it offers to the farmer. Did you remember the meaning of transplantation? Transferring a seedling from the nursery or from small plot to a big field for the proper cultivation and agricultural practices, it is termed as transplantation. Now we have to list down the two advantages that this transplantation offers the farmer. Okay, transplantation, first of all, in a nursery bed, when many of the seeds are sown and seedlings are prepared, the farmers got the or farmers have the opportunity to select the healthy seedlings. They can select only the healthy and a good seeds which yield more crop production. So first offer that one, that the farmers have the opportunity to select only the healthy seedlings from the nursery or from a small plot. You can see what I have written here. Transplantation, it is a process of transferring a fully grown seedling and replanting it in a stable location, that is field. Once again, it is a process of transferring a fully grown seedling, means from seed to seedling, when it is grown into a small plot or in a nursery, and after that the farmer select it and replant. Once again, it is taken out from the small plant and again it is planted into a big field or a stable location for proper cultivation. It is termed as transplantation. Now, what are the two advantages they offer to the farmers? First one, the farmers can selectively cultivate only healthy plants. They can select only healthy plants from the nursery bed. Number two, the plants can be planted at appropriate distance. The between the two seedlings, between the two seedlings, a proper distance can be maintained, which help in proper growth of the seedlings into a young and matured plant. Because if the distance is maintained, then there will not be any fight for the light or the minerals from the soil or for the space. Once again, as we all know, that dispersal of seed is very important, that we had read in our last year, that if the seeds are dispersed at a very far places, then the seeds will not have any fight for the space, light and other requirement. Here also, when the seedlings are brought from the small plot and when it is planted into a big field, the farmers plant the seedlings at a proper distance. Then what will happen? The seedlings will grow in a full bloom. They will not fight or they will not have any chaos for the space. The root will spread properly and the minerals from the soil will be appropriate for each plant for their growth. So these two advantages that the farmer gets for after the process of transplantation. We have two examples. One is paddy plant, another one tomatoes. So today's work is, do part D in your biocopy. That's all in today's class. Thank you. Bye-bye.